Today we are going to discuss a course that is Control Systems Engineering. Its code is E351. This course is common for B.Tech 5th semester Electronics and Electrical Board. Now, Control Systems Engineering. The name suggests that there is a system. It can be any physical system in which we can apply some input over here and we can have some output here. Now, we need some desired output of this particular system by applying a particular input. Now, this system, which is the physical system, it has some variables that may have the effect of so many parameters like temperature or humidity, because of which it can change or it can force this particular system to have the variations in the output. And since there will be a variation in the output, we find that it is going away from the desired one, and so hence we need something or some mechanism within the system that should give us the desired output. So there the term control works now. Now, in this particular system, we are going to put some methodology or the mechanism for controlling of those changes in the output by controlling those variables which are affecting this chain in the output. So that mechanism is nothing but engineering. So this control system engineering, in this subject we are going to learn the working of the system or the function of the system, the effect of the parameters or the variables of this particular physical system on the output, and how to control those changes or how to control those variables by using certain mechanisms. Now, in short, we can say that this control system, it is nothing but an arrangement of physical components which may have some variables. For example, we can say that the angular position, temperature, speed, which can be controlled to have the desired output or the desired manner of that particular variable values. Now, it is basically classified as, number one, open loop control system, and number two, that is closed loop control system. Now, first of all, we will discuss this open loop control system. In the first, in short, we can write this as OLCS, that is open loop control system. Now, in this case, let us consider there is a controller which is going to produce a signal or some signals which can control the operation of the plant. So here we have the plant. Let us say here we are getting the output. We are applying over here as input. So some inputs are applied and accordingly we are getting the output. Now, this particular controller, this will actuate the signals in reference to the input for controlling of this particular plant. And this plant, this is the important part of this particular system which is responsible for generating a particular output based on the input signals. Now, this can be represented as G of S. Here, let us say the input signal is R of S and the output is C of S, where we can say let us consider that R of S, this is the Laplace transform of input signal. This is the Laplace transform of input signal, that is R of T. Now the question is, why we are taking this Laplace transform? Basically, in the control system, we are dealing with the system. It can be the mechanical, electrical, hydraulic, and these systems are governed or represented by some differential equations. And these differential equations are to be solved for analysis of this particular system. Now, this Laplace transform, it facilitates us, or this Laplace transform transforms this time domain differential equation into the frequency domain algebraic form. And for analysis of this control system, we need the algebraic equations. So that is why we are using this Laplace transform, so that the time domain differential equation of a particular system, that can be converted into the frequency domain signal. Now, R of S is the Laplace transform equals R of T. Similarly, the C of S, This is the Laplace transform of output signal C of t. In this case, the time domain is converted into the frequency domain. And this G of s, this is the forward path gain. This is called as forward path gain because in this case, we are here, we are applying the input, and at the next end, we are getting the output. So this is the forward path, which is moving from input to output. And the gain of this particular system is G of s. So this is the representation of the open loop system. Now let's see the closed loop control system. Now the second one is closed loop control system. Here we will use a mixer, or we can also call it as a comparator. Let us say this is input signal. Here we have the control element. Then here there is a plant. And let's say this is the output. Output is represented as E of S, similarly input is represented as R of S. And we can have a feedback path, and this feedback path is, we can say it's a sensor. This is feedback path, and this is mixed, the signal is mixed with the input signal. Let us say this is B of S, this is error signal, that is E of S. So this is comparator. Now if you compare this with the open loop system, we will find that here the controller is made up of the mixer circuit and the control element. So the combination of this control element and the mixer, that makes the controller. So this is the controller. Now if you compare this closed loop control system with the open loop system, this is the open loop system where we have the controller, and here there is a plant. We are getting the output over here and we are applying the input R of S. Now this is open loop control system, this is closed loop control system. Let us say this is figure A and this is figure B. Now if we compare these two figures, now let's see here. In this case, we do not have any feedback path from output side to the input side. That means the output is not influencing the working or the functioning of this plant. I mean, there is no control over the changes in the output. If there are some disturbance signals, let's consider that some disturbance signals are applied over here. Now, if some disturbance signals are given, then what is going to happen? These disturbance signals may affect the functioning of this plant, due to which there will be a variation in the output. So the exact output which was desired, now that is going to change. And this variations is not going to influence the working of this controller or the plant. That is why we will always have the variation in the output and will not get the desired result in this circuit, in this particular system. Whereas here, this mixer will take care of these problems. In this case, what is happening? The output part is fed back to the input side, to the mixer circuit. Here, we can use this as a plus and minus, plus or minus. Either this signal will be added to the input signal, or this will be subtracted from the input signal. And that is why we are calling this E of S as error signal. This is error signal. Now here, in this case, let us consider again there is some disturbance signals occur inside this plant. Now because of this disturbance signal, what will happen? We can have the variations in the output. Now because of the variations in the output, it is going away from the desired one. So since we have the feedback part, or we are using the sensor, so it will take care of the variations in the output. So whatever be the variations in the output, those variations will be given to the input side through this feedback path. Because of use of this particular sensor, it will take care of the variations in the output. Accordingly, it is going to change the value of those parameter which is affecting the variation in the output, so that again it will go to its desired value. So in this case, we can say that in the closed loop control system, output or the variation in the output, this is influencing the functioning of this controller. That means the functioning of this control element, and hence it is controlling the operation of plant. So in this case, we can define this closed loop and open loop as, in open loop control system, this is a system in which we do not have automatic correction to the variations of the output. Whereas in a closed loop control system, this is the system in which we can have the automatic correction for the variation in the output because of this feedback signal. So here, the gain of this feedback path, I will remove this since we have seen the comparison, the gain of this feedback path is represented as H of S. So this is the gain for the feedback path. Here we have the gain for the forward path, that is G of S. So we use the same thing. If we compare, if we see this particular structure, we find that R of S is again the Laplace transform of input signal R of T. C of S is the Laplace transform of output signal C of T. G of S is the forward path gain. And here we have added one more gain, that is H of S. This is feedback path. Now let us compare the input and open loop system and the closed loop system. And so we'll see the advantages and disadvantages of this, and then we will do the analysis of this. This is open loop control system. Here you can have the closed loop control system. Now number one, if you see the cost, means how much we are going to pay for making of a system, whether it's open loop control system or the closed loop control system. As we have seen that in the open loop control system, it consists of a controller, a plant, and we are getting the output as per the given input. So we can say it is low cost. The open loop control system is low cost. Whereas the closed loop control system, it is not only having the controller and the plant, but it also has a feedback path. And the feedback path, it can be the active and passive components. It consists of the active and passive components. So that also gives cost, add cost to that. And so we can say that it is costly. Then second, how to build in the construction? Open loop control system, this is easy to construct. So here, this is easy to construct. And closed loop control system, this is complex. For controlling of this control system, or for making of the system, the construction is very complex, since it consists of so many circuits and the components. And third one, as far as the calibration is concerned, as far as the calibration is good, we can have the system is accurate. But of course, it is not as accurate as compared to the closed loop control system. So it totally depends on the calibration, means how it is calibrated. If the system is calibrated up to a proper extent, then we can have the system is more accurate. Whereas in the closed loop control system, since it is taking care of the variations in the output, we can say that this is more accurate as compared to open loop control system. So if you compare these two, open loop control system and closed loop control system, open loop control system is low cost. If you see, if you compare the structure of open loop and closed loop, we can easily say that the cost that we are going to pay for the making of the open loop control system is less as compared to that of the closed loop control system, because it has many blocks more than in the open loop control system. Now for the construction, the same thing. As we go on adding the components, or as we go on adding some blocks in the system, the system is going to be complex. So the construction will be very complex. It will be complicated as compared to that of the open loop control system. Now, for the accuracy, since in the open loop control system, we don't have any control over that. Once the input is applied, the controller will actuate the signal and it will ask the plant to perform certain operations, and accordingly we can have the desired output. So here, if the calibration is perfect, if we are using a very good calibration to the system, then we have the accurate result. But of course, since we are doing the calibration, it may not give the accurate result as that of the control closed loop control system. Whereas, since in this case we have the feedback path, which is influencing the control output because of the variations of the output, so it will give the more accurate result as compared to that of the open loop control system. Now you can see the example. Means what are the examples of open loop control system and closed loop control system? We can say there is an automatic washing machine. Automatic washing machine, this is the example of open loop control system. We can say the toast maker, this is also an open loop control system. We can have fan, once the switch is on, once we have set the calibration to a particular regulator value, it will give the particular speed of that particular fan. Similarly, the toast maker, we can fix the time and it will generate the output. Similarly, the washing machine, we can put everything, detergent, water and everything, and we will set a particular time over there and it will perform the working till that particular time. So this is open loop control system, it is not taking any feedback. We are using ourselves as a controller, we are setting a particular value of that variable that is called as the functioning of controller, and the client, that means in the washing machine, the machine will work as per the desired value given, as per the required variable value given by the user. So these are the open loop control system, these are the examples of the open loop control system. And for the closed loop, we can see the example is pointing a finger to an object. Right? If this is a particular object, if I am pointing a finger to it, basically I am getting a feedback by my eye. I am looking towards this particular object and then I am having this signal from my spinal cord to brain that to show the finger over here. So it's complete the closed loop control system. In this case, I am getting the feedback signal from my eye, eyes are the sensors, and then I am pointing the finger over here. So this is the example for the closed loop control system. A. In B, driving a car. Again, the human eye is a sensor. Brain is also used as a sensor. That means we are using the sensor as an eye, and whatever we are looking at the road, similarly, the signal is generated from the brain through spinal cord, and the man drives a particular car as per the requirement. So that is the example for the closed loop control system. So these are the basic examples. We can have many examples for this. Now we'll try to analyze this open loop control system and the closed loop control system. We will see how to solve this particular system by using the method. So first of all, we will discuss the open loop control system. Now we have seen that the open loop control system is simply generated or represented as, we can have the forward path gain, that is G of S. We can have the input, that is R of S, and the output is C of S. So this is the particular system where we are applying the input as R of S, gain is G of S, and the output is C of S. Now here, basically the gain of this path is always multiplied. Means, if you want to find the value of the C of S, the third variable, if you consider these three as the variables R of S, G of S, and C of S, then C of S will be always the product of these two, the last two. So in this case, we can have this as C of S equals to G of S multiplied by R of S. Now, the question is why we are going to analyze this? Basically, we are trying to follow the, we are trying to find the transfer function. What is transfer function? In a linear time invariant system, we are calling it as a linear system. The linear system means the output exactly proportional to the input, where we can say the superposition theorem holds good. So that is a linear system. Time invariant, which is not variant, which is invariant to the time, that means time independent system. So in a linear time invariant system, This transfer function is defined as the ratio of Laplace transform of output signal to the input signal. Or in short, we can say that this transfer function is Laplace transform of output signal over Laplace transform of input signal. So this gives the transfer function. So here we know that this C of S, this is the Laplace transform of C of T, that is output, and R of S, this is the Laplace transform of R of T. So in this case, input is R of T, output is C of T. So R of S, this is the Laplace transform of input signal, C of S, this is the Laplace transform of input signal. So in this case, the transfer function will be C of S over R of S. So this is the transfer function. So what is C of S over R of S? From this equation, it is G of S. So the transfer function for the open loop control system is simply the forward path gain, that is G of S. Now we'll see for the closed loop control system. I'll draw it over here. We have seen the structure of the closed loop control system, where we have the input, let us say this is the Laplace transform of the input signal, that is R of S. Here we have the gain of forward path, that is G of S. Here we have the output, Laplace transform output signal, so it is C of S. And here we are going to represent the feedback path gain with H of S. The output of this mixer, this is E of S, which is error signal. This is error signal. Here we are using it as feedback output, so this is B of S. Now we have seen that this can be either added or subtracted. So according to the addition or subtraction of this feedback signal to the input signal, this closed loop control system is further categorized as A, negative feedback control system, or B, positive feedback control system. You can also call it as negative feedback closed loop control system or closed loop control system with negative feedback. We can use this as positive feedback control system or positive feedback closed loop control system or closed loop control system with positive feedback. Only difference is that in the negative feedback, this error signal will be generated by subtracting this E of S, which is the output of this feedback path, from the input signal, that is R of S. And in the positive feedback control signals, this B of S, which is the output of this feedback part, is going to be added with R of S to get the error signal E of S. Now we'll discuss this too. First, let us say A, that is negative feedback control system. Now in this case, the structure will be the same, only that here we are going to use the negative sign. So here we have R of S. I'll draw it fast. This is E of S. Here we have again G of S. Here it is E of S. And the feedback we are using H of S. And the output is B of S. Since we are using this as negative feedback, so it is going to be subtracted from this. So here, just now we have discussed that for the negative feedback control system, the error signal is generated by subtracting this B of S, that is the output of this feedback, from the input R of S. So this E of S is R of S minus B of S. Now we apply the same methodology for getting the values of all these variables. So E of S is R of S minus B of S. What is C of S then? C of S will be G of S multiplied by E of S. Again, we have discussed that for getting the prime of this third variable, you have to multiply this two. So E of S is the multiplication of G of S and E of S. Similarly, this P of S will be given as H of S multiplied by C of S. Now let us use this particular equation, that is C of S equals to G of S multiplied by E of S, because the ultimate goal is to get the value of transfer function. And of course, in this case, the transfer function, that is for the closed loop control system, whether it is negative feedback control system or the positive feedback control system, the transfer function will be C of S divided by R of S. That is the ratio of Laplace transform of output signal to the Laplace transform of input signal. So let's explore this equation again. So C of S, which is equals to G of S multiplied by E of S. Now we'll substitute the value of this E of S into this equation. So here, if we substitute this value, let us say this is expression A, this is B, and this is equation C. So substitute equation of, or the value of E of S from equation A in equation C. So what is going to happen? Here we will have the value S. C of S is equals to G of S multiplied by E of S from A is, this is R of S minus B of S. So this is the value. Now, let us say this is equation number D. Now this D is consisting of C of S, G of S, R of S and B of S. Basically this B of S, this we are assuming that this is the output of this feedback signal, which is given as H of S multiplied by C of S. Here we are using this signal as error signal, E of S, which is giving the difference between these two, since it is negative feedback control system. It is R of S minus D of S. So from this transfer function, we'll have to eliminate this E of S and B of S term so that we can have the final result, which is in terms of GS and HS. Because in this case, this is actually the gain of forward path gain and this is the gain of feedback path gain. So the output as transfer function, that should always give the values in terms of only the forward path gain and the feedback path gain. So we are trying to eliminate this E of S and B of S. By using this substitution, we have eliminated E of S. Now, since we have this B of S, we also have to eliminate this B of S by putting the value of B of S from equation C into the equation D. Now here, substitute equation of B of S from C in D. Now, after substituting, we can have this as C of S, that is equals to G of S multiplied by R of S minus B of S is H of S and then C of S. So we are having this as C of S equals to G of S multiplied by R of S minus H of S, C of S. Now this can be written as GSRS minus GSHS CS. Now these two terms are common, that is CS. So we will bring this term of CS in the left hand side. So this becomes CS multiplied by 1 minus G of S, 1 plus, this will be positive since it is coming to the left hand side, GSHS, that is equals to GSRS. Now for the transfer function, we know that it is given as C of S over R of S. So we rearrange this expression and we have this result as G of S over 1 plus GS HS. So this is the final transfer function for the negative feedback control system, that is GS over 1 plus GS HS. Now we'll do these calculations for positive feedback control system. positive feedback control system, as we have discussed, only the error signal generated will be the addition of input signal and the output of the feedback signal, that is B of S. So here we have G of S, output is C of S, and this is feedback through H of S, and this term will be positive. So in this case, E of S will be R of S plus V of S. We know that C of S is G of S multiplied by E of S, and B of S, this is given as H of S multiplied by C of S. So now again we use this C of S. So C of S is equals to G of S E of S. Now again we are trying to eliminate the term E of S and B of S. So here it can be represented as G of S, E of S can be replaced by R of S plus B of S. Now we will have to eliminate this B of S terms, as we have done for the negative feedback system. G of S multiplied by R of S plus B of S is HS, CS. So this is H of S, C of X. Now this, I will rearrange this. So G of S, R of S plus G of S, H of S, C of S. And here we have C of S. Now I'll use here. So C of S equals G of S, R of S plus G S, H S, C of S. Now bring this C of S terms towards left hand side. So this will give us C of S multiplied by 1. Now it will be negative since we are bringing the positive term. G S HS, which is equals to GS RS. Now we know that the transfer function is C of S over R of S, that is Laplace transform output signal to Laplace transform input signal. So that is given as G of S over 1 minus G of S HS. So this is the transfer function of positive feedback closed loop control system. So if you compare these two, that is, this is the transfer function of negative feedback. This is all negative feedback, and this is for the positive feedback. If you compare this, there is only difference of this positive and negative type. So I hope you are getting all the methods or the process that we have followed for analyzing this particular open loop system and closed loop control system. For reading of this particular topic from the book, you can refer the book for the topics that I have covered today. There are many books, but you can use the book which is easy to understand. And the textbooks that we are able to follow are, number one, the book by B.S. Manke, that is Linear Control System. It's a Khanna Publishers. And the second book you can refer, Nagarath and Gopal, it is Control Systems Engineering. And the publisher is New Age International Publisher. So for this particular subject, we are going to use these two books, that is B.S. Manke Linear Control System, Khanna Publishers, and Nagarath and Gopal Control Systems Engineering, New Age International Publishers, for learning of this control system engineering. I hope you have understood the topic that we have covered till now. In the next lecture, we will see how to analyze the forward path signals and the feedback path signals. Means this is the simplest one. Now in the next lecture, we are going to have the look at the complex control systems, where we can have so many blocks in the forward path as well as in the feedback path. We will have so many points or the interfacing, and that way we will see how to eliminate this so that we can fix up the formula that just now we have generated, that is the transfer function for the negative feedback control system as C of S over R of S equals to GS over 1 plus GSHS, whereas for the positive feedback it will be GS over 1 minus GSHS. Thank you.